Hi, my students in grade 6. This is a new mathematics lecture in semester 2, the academic year 2020-2021. This is lecture 5, and the title of our lecture is Triangles. Of course, I have written 1 because this is part 1 of our lesson Triangles, and we will have another part in this lesson. The objectives of our lesson. Objective number 1, we will identify a triangle and its elements. What do we have in a triangle? Objective number 2, we will learn a very important thing concerning triangles, which is the sum of angles in a triangle is 180 degrees. Objective number 3, we will identify together special triangles and their properties. We have special kinds of triangles, of course. We will know what are these special triangles, and we will learn together the properties of each kind of these triangles. First, definition and characteristics. If you look here, you will see this shape. This shape in math, in geometry, we call it a triangle. The word triangle, it is 2 words. What do we mean when we say triangle? When we say triangle, this means the word tri and the word angle. So in the word triangle, we have tri and angle. The word tri means 3 in mathematics. So tri is 3. Again, a triangle is a polygon. What do we mean by a polygon? It is a geometrical shape. It is a shape in mathematics having always in any triangle, what do we have? We have 3 sides, we have 3 angles, and we have 3 vertices. As you can see here, everything or every element, we have 3 of it. That's why we call it a tri. So 3 sides again, 3 angles, and 3 vertices. This definition and these elements should be memorized. Let us practice what we did here on this triangle. So this shape, we call it a triangle. First, let us see the sides. What are the sides? This line, as you can see, this line, we call it a side. So this is side 1. This line also is called a side. So this is side 2. This line is also called a side. This is side 3. So in every triangle we have, this is a side. Sorry, this is a side, this is the first side, the second side, the third side. So these are the 3 sides. And in every triangle, we have 3 vertices. If you look here, this side intersects with the second side at a point. This red point where the 2 sides intersect, we call it a vertex. So this is a vertex. This side will intersect with this side in a vertex. So this side will intersect in a point. We call it a vertex. Also, this side will intersect with the second side in this point. And this point, we call it a vertex. So till now, we have 3 sides. We have the plural of the word vertex is vertices. So this is a vertex. This is a vertex, this is a vertex. The 3 of them, we call them vertices. Now the angles. The space between 2 intersecting lines. Here we have an angle, so this is an angle. Also here down we have an angle, and here we have an angle. So please watch what I discussed now carefully, because they are very important to know. What is a side, what is a vertex, and what is an angle? Let me erase this, what I did here, and I will continue now. Let's practice this exercise together. We can see that we have a triangle. The first vertex is called A. The second vertex is called B. The third vertex is called C. Now, in this triangle, we should name the three sides. To name the sides, we name the lines. And always to name a line, we should find two points, a starting point and an ending point. So this line starts at A and ends at B. So this is called AB. So this is side AB. So the first side, we call it AB. The second side, it starts at A and ends at C. So we call it AC directly. The third side starts at B and ends at C. So we call it BC, or we can call it CB in the opposite. Now let's name the three vertices. This point here where the two lines intersect, it's called the first vertex A. This point here is called the vertex B. And this point here is called the vertex C. Now let's name the angles. Of course, you know, to name an angle, we choose a vertex. Here at vertex A, let's name the angle. Always to name the angle, the vertex should be in the middle. So it's called BAC or CAB. This is the vertex at A, it's called BAC. The angle at vertex B, we call it ABC. So B should be in the middle of the name of the angle. The third angle at vertex C, we call it ACB. So C should be in the middle of the name of the angle. This is how we name sides, we name vertices, and we name angles in any triangle. This slide has something or has a sentence in it, which you should never forget in your life. This sentence is very important, so always remember this. This is the important sentence that you should memorize now. The sum of angles in a triangle is 180 degrees. Let's go to this exercise here. This is angle BAC at vertex A. This angle has a measure in degrees. The angle at vertex B, which is ABC, also has a measure in degrees. The angle at vertex C, which is ACB, also has a measure in degrees. What do we mean by this sentence? This means if I add, the sum means add. If I add the measure at the vertex A of the angle at vertex A, if I add the measure of this angle with the measure of this angle, with the measure of this angle, the sum or the answer of addition should always be 180 degrees. So this sentence is very important. Let's practice an exercise. We have this triangle PQR. I can see that the angle at vertex P is 70 degrees. This angle at vertex Q is 30 degrees. This angle at vertex R is 80 degrees. If I add 70 degrees plus 30 degrees plus 80 degrees, I will get 180 degrees. So this shape is a triangle. This is triangle PQR. In the second triangle, if I add the measure of this angle plus the measure of this angle plus the measure of this angle, their sum should be 180 degrees. So if I added 65 degrees plus 30 degrees plus 85 degrees, their measure should be 180 degrees. So the sum of all the angles in any triangle should always be 180 degrees. Now, there are special kinds of triangles. Why are they special? Because they have something very special in them. This makes them special. So these special kinds of triangles are triangle number one, read after me, please. Scalene triangle. Scalene triangle. Triangle number two, right triangle. Three, isosceles triangle. Isosceles triangle. Triangle number four, equilateral triangle. Triangle number five, right isosceles triangle. Now I will talk about each one of them alone. Triangle number one, which is the scalene triangle. This definition should be memorized. A scalene triangle, it is a normal triangle with no equal sides, no equal angles, and no right angle in it. So if we look at this triangle here, we can see that this side measures 7 centimeters, this side measures 12 centimeters, this side measures 15 centimeters. So no equal sides. The angle here is different than the measure of this angle, is different than the measure of this angle, so we have no equal angles. Also in this triangle, we can see no right angle equal to 90 degrees. So this triangle is called a scalene triangle, which is a normal triangle. So this definition should be memorized. The second kind of triangles is the right triangle. Which triangle we call it a right triangle? A right triangle is a triangle that has one right angle in it. We know that in any triangle, we have three angles. In the right triangle, one of the three angles is right, which is equal to 90 degrees. Suppose if I have this triangle and I look in it, I can see a right angle in it. Because there's a right angle here, so I directly say this triangle is a right triangle. Also, this triangle is a right triangle. In any right triangle, this is the right angle. We have an opposite side to the right angle, which is the side facing the right angle. So if this is the right angle, the opposite side is this. Always the opposite side to the right angle, we call it a hypotenuse. So this line or this side in the right triangle is called a hypotenuse since it's opposite to the 90 degrees angle or to the right angle. Also in this triangle, if this is the right angle, the opposite side is called the hypotenuse. We still have two other sides. This is the first side and this is the second side. Because they form a right angle in between, then we say that these two sides are perpendicular to each other. So in any right triangle, there is a special side opposite to the right angle, which is called the hypotenuse, and the other two sides are perpendicular to each other since they form a right angle in between. Now we move to the third kind of triangles, which is called the isosceles triangle. Isosceles triangle. This definition is very important. The isosceles triangle, it has two equal sides and two equal angles. So in any isosceles triangle, we have two equal sides and two equal angles. If we look at this triangle, EDF, this is a triangle. It is isosceles of vertex E. So in any isosceles triangle, we have a special vertex. Yes, it has a three vertices, but one of the three vertices in an isosceles triangle is special because the two equal sides I talked about here are issued or coming out from the special vertex. As you can see, side ED and side EF have the same marks on them. So side ED is equal to side EF. Then the special vertex is E. Leave the special vertex aside. I still have two other vertices, vertex D and vertex F. On vertex D, we have an angle, which is EDF. On vertex F, there is an angle, which is EFD. These two angles are the equal angles. So to know the equal angles, we put the special vertex aside. On the other two vertices, we have the two equal angles. So again, in any isosceles triangle, we have a special vertex or a special point. The two equal sides are issued from the special vertex. The word issued means, this word issued means coming out from the special vertex. And the other two angles are on the other two vertices. Also, this side, which is opposite to the special vertex in an isosceles triangle, we call it a base. Number four, equilateral triangle. Equilateral, it has three equal sides and three equal angles. Each angle measures 60 degrees. In any equilateral triangle, suppose EFG is an equilateral triangle. Directly I say side EF is equal to side EG is equal to side FG. So if EF is 4 centimeters, EG is also 4 centimeters, and FG is also 4 centimeters. Each angle in an equilateral triangle measures 60 degrees. This is 60 degrees. This is 60 degrees and this is 60 degrees. Why? Because we said that if I added this angle with this angle with this angle, they will be 180. So if I divide 180 over 3 because they are equal, then each angle will be measuring 60 degrees. In triangle RST, let's name the equal sides. RS is equal to RT is equal to ST. And this angle is 60 degrees, this angle is 60 degrees, this angle is 60 degrees. The final triangle is the right isosceles triangle. It's very easy, right? It has one of its angles 90 degrees. Isosceles, it has two equal sides and two equal angles. Suppose this triangle is a right isosceles, then this angle is 90 degrees. The side opposite to it is called a hypotenuse. From this special vertex where we have a right angle, the two equal sides are issued. Then this side is equal to this side. So if this angle is 90 degrees, this and this together will also be 90 degrees. Why? Because 180 minus 90, I still have 90. Since they are equal, so in a right isosceles triangle, one angle is 90 degrees, the other two angles, each one will be 45 degrees. So again, these special kinds of triangles, we should study the definition of each one of them and know the characteristics of each one of them alone. Now let's practice this exercise together. Specify the special elements in the following triangles. Part A, triangle EFG is equilateral. So directly, I should stop at the word equilateral. I ask myself, what does the word equilateral mean? Equilateral means this triangle has three equal sides and the three equal angles. This is the definition of an equilateral triangle. Now let's name the equal sides. Now it's very easy to name the equal sides. I start from E. I say EF is the first side, EG is the second side, and FG is the third side. So these are the equal sides. The equal sides are EF is equal to EG is equal to FG. Now the equal angles. At vertex E is the first angle. Let's name the angle at vertex E. So E should be in the middle. The angle at vertex E is FEG or GEF. The angle at vertex F is EFG. The angle at vertex G is EGF. So these three angles are equal, and each one of them measures 60 degrees. So also this is angle EGF, and each one of these three angles, of course, has the measure of 60 degrees. Why? Because we said in an equilateral triangle, each angle measures 60 degrees. Now, also the same example, but I changed the name of the triangle. DEF is an equilateral triangle. So because it's equilateral, it has three equal sides, three equal angles. Let's name the equal sides. I start from D. DE is the first side, DF is the second side, and EF is the third side. So these three sides are equal. To name the angles that are equal, at each vertex, I name an angle. Let's name the angle at vertex D. So I should use the three vertices, but D should be in the middle. Always the angle you are naming, its vertex should be in the middle. So EDF or DEF is equal to DFE is equal to EDF. Of course, each one of the three angles is equal to 60 degrees. Part C, KLM is a right triangle at L. I stop at the word right and I ask myself, what does the word right mean? Right triangle means one of its angles is equal to 90 degrees. Since it's right at L, then the angle at vertex L should be 90 degrees. I go to the name of the triangle and above L, I put an X. Why? Because I should know that vertex L on it, we have the angle which is equal to 90 degrees. Let's name the angle at vertex L. So L should be in the middle. The angle at vertex L is KLM is equal to 90 degrees. Also, we know that in a right triangle, we have a hypotenuse, which is opposite to the right angle. So if the right angle is at L, the hypotenuse will be, of course, KM is the hypotenuse. Here I have, sorry, a typing mistake. So K, let me erase it and write it again. So, sorry. Again, the the hypotenuse. Again, I will say this is a typing mistake. So, of course, the hypotenuse is KM. KM will be the hypotenuse in this triangle. Now, triangle ABC is right at A. So I put an X over the A. If you do what I'm doing, it will ease your work. So A is where the angle is equal to 90 degrees. Let's name the angle at vertex A. So A should be in the middle. Its name is BAC is equal to 90 degrees or CAB is equal to 90 degrees. So who will be my hypotenuse? Of course, BC. If I put A aside, then BC will be my hypotenuse. It will be opposite to the A angle. E, M and P is an isosceles triangle of vertex M. I stop at the word isosceles and I ask myself, what does an isosceles triangle have? An isosceles triangle has two equal sides and two equal angles. Who's the special vertex? It's M. So I go to the name of the triangle and above the special vertex, I put an X. Now, the two equal sides are issued from M. So I start from M. MN is the first side, then MP is the second side. So the equal sides are MN equal MP. Also, it has two equal angles. If the special vertex is M, I put it aside. Then the equal angles will be at vertex N and at vertex P. Let's name the angle at vertex M. It is MNP. NP, of course, is the base. MNP is equal to MPN. Also, RST is an isosceles triangle of vertex S. Because the special vertex is S, so I put an X above X. Now, the equal sides are issued from S. So the first side is SR, the second side is ST. So SR is equal to ST. Of course, the base is RT. And the equal angles, the first angle is at vertex R, the second angle is at vertex T. So it is SRT is equal to STR. This exercise is very, very, very important. So this exercise is a very important exercise. Please after watching the video, after studying the definitions that I told you about, you should practice this exercise because it's really a very important exercise. Now, I really thank you, my dear students. And until we meet, of course, as I always say, please keep safe.